This is Charisse Mathis, and she is a boy preschool mom. That's right. And she just knows how to love her family and love them really hard, and especially during this quarantine time. So, Charisse, how old are your boys?
They are 2 and 3.
When we talk about preschool, like, you are busy in those ages.
Yeah. I noticed, like, my kids, 2 and 3 years old, they're super content being at home.
So true.
And they don't even notice that we're not going out. So we've noticed that, you know, even though we might feel a little restless, whatever, we don't try to communicate that with the kids and say, oh, we're bored, because we don't want them to be saying, oh, we're bored all day. Because they're really content, like, throwing pillows on the floor, jumping around. So
I think that's so important to remember, too. Like, just because they're preschoolers, they don't see what we see. Like, they're not necessarily going to the grocery stores and seeing some empty aisles, or going to Target and seeing people wear masks. Like, you don't have to wear masks at home. So to understand that they're content during this time, I think, is a really good realization.
Yeah. Yeah, it's so true. Because, you know, our house is pretty small and cozy. And then I'm always thinking, like, oh, we need a bigger space. But they're really content with what we have. And it's just cool to see.
Yeah. The things are never going to be the same. And that's just a reality. But, like, when we get to get back to something of normal, right? Yeah. Like, what are some things that you're like, you know, we started that. Let's keep on doing that.
Yeah. I actually started cooking more.
Yeah, Charisse.
Yeah, girl.
Yeah, so, and if you're like me and need some assistance with that, I would recommend, like, texting some of your mom friends and asking them, what are you cooking? Getting some ideas. I lived in my house for 2 years, and there has been house chores that I have not even gotten around to until now.
Well, because it's just so busy.
Yeah.
Like, you are going from thing to thing to thing. Let's just talk about being at home right now, right? Like, you still don't have the margin, because you feel guilty about, you know, maybe sitting your kids to watch TV so you can clean something, because you want to spend the time that you have with them and use the quarantine time to really build into the relationships, right? So, like, even that is true. But I just want to go back to your cooking. I love that she even talked about, like, the different foods that you've noticed your boys like. Oh, and so she's learned how to cook them like your mom would, right?
Yeah. So, you know, they're 2 and 3, so they're picky eaters. But then I noticed, I was like, I don't want to just say they're picky eaters. I noticed that there's some foods that they just really enjoy.
Yeah.
So I've learned to cook, like, more like a Filipino food specifically for my family. It's actually been fun, because I've been going with my dad, my mom and dad, to, like, the Filipino market and, like, learning how to cook that type of food. So that's a big thing.
That's awesome. Like, I love it. And I think that then really puts your culture into everything too, right?
Yeah.
Because then if you're cooking it, your boys are going to enjoy it. And hopefully one day you can cook, you can teach them what you're learning now in quarantine.
Yeah.
You get to teach them because you have the skills yourself.
Yeah.
Which obviously they'll still learn from your mom and all that kind of stuff too. But to pass that down during generations, I think is such a gift.
Yeah.
Like, that is such a gift for you to do.
Yeah.
So what has been hard in quarantine? And is there something that has helped you to overcome it so that then maybe when that situation comes up again, it might not be as difficult? Or what is something that you've really struggled with, but guess what? We figured out how to overcome that.
Yeah, so, you know, being really vulnerable, you guys, it is a hard time for a lot of people, even though I said it is, I enjoyed it being productive. It is really hard to be at home all day, every day with your family, where there's a lot of servitude included, and you're constantly, constantly serving and picking up after your family.
Yes.
So what I noticed, I was like, I realized one day, and I called Chris and I called my small group, and I was like, I have an anger issue. And then I realized, like, I don't want to be an angry mom. Mm. And although we know that we all love our kids, and I love my kids, we'll do anything for our kids. But to admit that and to realize, okay, I need a counselor, I want to get a little bit of help in this area, has helped me. And I reached out to the Life Center here at Hope Church and just said, hey, I just want to talk it out. And I think with counseling and therapy, that's something that we should never look down on.
Yes.
Because we all need it. And so, you know, just reaching out to my counselor via Zoom, we've been meeting on there.
Wow.
It's just giving me advice, like stuff like that. That's just so powerful. You know,
I agree.
Be able to share, and because I don't want my kids or my husband to be like a punching bag of my anger or whatever. And, you know, we have to think about, when it comes to being a mom or being a person, our whole bodies are connected. So, like, whether we're physically tired, spiritually, and how we're doing, all of it's connected. So if you're not getting enough sleep, if you're not taking care of ourselves, and it's all going to take part. So I think that, you know, just realize, just now the slowness has allowed us to, has allowed me to slow down and realize, okay, this is what I want to work on, and this is what I want to improve, and we have the time to do it.
I love it. And I think that we talk about like improving our house and cleaning our house, but sometimes we got to clean house in our own selves.
Yeah.
Exactly. And I really feel like that's what you're doing. You're taking the time to not just clean your house, not to just get to those nooks and crannies we don't get to, but cleaning house in your own heart. And especially like when you said counseling, sometimes we see that as like a crutch basically. I don't think it has to be that way. I think that if I had cancer, I'd go see a doctor and I wouldn't think twice about it. And I would obviously tell you as my friend, right? Like, go see a doctor.
Yeah.
But when our mind, sometimes we see that as a weakness, really, to go to a counselor. And so I love that you have realized something that you need is to go see a counselor. Our small group, she shared this, and it really like was a light switch in me to think ahead of time. Can you speak to that a little bit?
Yeah, so my counselor was sharing about, you know, when you're at work and there's a problem at work, we think of like A, B, C, D solutions on how to deal with that issue. Mm-hmm. Well, I didn't really think about it, but she was saying we need to do that with our own kids. So like, for example, if there is a time of day or a situation where you know your kids will just not act right during that time.
Yeah. Can you think of a time in your life where that's just a high stress point?
Yeah. So for me, it's like around dinner time. My boys are just waking up from their nap and I'm like cooking. Okay, like I mentioned before, I don't really enjoy cooking. I do it, but I don't enjoy cooking. So that's already like a high stress point for me, is being in the kitchen. And then and then my boys are wanting my attention during that time. So I'm trying to cook, the stove is hot, the boys are all over the kitchen trying
to— Can anybody relate with that? Like, for real.
Moving forward, I have to know, like, okay, this is the time where I have to spend, you know, quality focus time with my kids, maybe 15, 10 minutes before, or I have to tell my husband to take them out of the house while I'm cooking. You have to think ahead of how this is gonna happen, because there was one time where I was cooking and the food was almost burning. I was trying to focus on what Eli needed, and then the food is burning, and then I get mad and I blow up, and then you ask for forgiveness, and then it's just like not a good situation.
Girl, have we been there before?
Yeah. So really just getting ahead of it has helped me, and just really thinking about that, because we're problem solvers.
Yes.
But, you know, we have to create these scenarios with our kids in the future, because I don't want to like blow up on them knowing this is a normal thing.
Absolutely. And I think that with our coworkers, we even kind of hold back a little bit, right? Yeah. So like if you happen to work outside the home, or maybe you're even talking about like friends that you meet with at the park, you're not going to blow up on them. But I think that we almost consider it like a right to blow up on our kids sometimes, right? Like, you're irritating me and I'm going to blow up on you right now. And so I just feel like that is a normal part of family life.
Yeah.
Like, and then to be able to love on our kids like we would love on somebody that we don't even see as often or don't want to be as close to, is such a good realization.
Right.
I just want to say thank you so much for being a part of this, and for sharing your heart and being vulnerable, and then just sharing some good ideas of some things that we can do in quarantine.
Yeah.
You're doing a great job. You're an amazing mother, and I just can't wait to see what those boys grow up to be like. Like, isn't that kind of fun? Like, you get to think about that too. Like, what you are doing today matters, and what you do every single day, Charisse, to just pour into these kids' lives, it matters. And what you're doing today is building the foundation to what they're going to be older.
Yeah.
And so thank you so much for doing that. We appreciate you.
Thank you.